no, I've got the smart one down here this morning. Oh, darn it. Look, he looks so snappy. Well, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Okay, let's try. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. Oh my gosh. You guys can do better. Good morning.
Good morning.
Say.
More feminine.
Yeah, well, you're young. And much louder. Oh,
there's
boy, I live with them. So, this morning, we are going to try to make something out of this box. Hopefully, it's not breakable. There is something in this box that I get to make a children's message out of. Well, let's see what they have given me this morning. They like to call this stump the pastor because they're trying to stump the pastor or stump the mom or stump the person who's up here trying to make a children's message. So, all right, this is like crazy, all right? I don't know who did this to me. There is a tissue.
Hey, I got one.
You got one?
I got
one. You got one too?
I got some home.
Yeah?
I got some home.
Got some at home?
Cool.
It's a dime. You can't even make a phone call with a dime anymore. Oh, like sticky notes. Oh, you may have done it this morning when we did this. Okay, so we've got a blank sticky note, a dime, and a tissue. What do we use tissue? I'm just making this up as I go along. Okay, what do we usually use tissues for? To blow our nose.
Tears.
Tears.
Fuel for a furnace.
Fuel for a furnace. Okay, yeah. It burns. You're right. He's right. Fuel for a furnace. Oh, Lord, I'm so glad you're back here. Okay, so we use tissues for that, right? What do we use a dime for? What can we use to use a dime for?
Make
a phone call. Yeah.
Melt it down in said furnace.
Melting it down in said furnace. I have a feeling I know where you're going with this. Melting it down in said furnace.
Well, you can also buy candy with it.
You can buy candy with it? Where can you get candy for a dime nowadays? Even penny candy costs you 5 cents now. So you get 2 pieces of candy for 10 cents, right?
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. A dime. Used to call, melting it. Sticky notes. What do we use sticky notes for?
You can throw it in the fire. That kid is talking about.
Go ahead.
Label said furnace so no one jumps into it.
Label said furnace so no one jumps into it. I like him. He's got it. You know, he can talk about furnaces, fiery furnaces. You know Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego?
Yes.
You know? Benny and
Rack, Shack, and Benny,
right? They went into a fiery furnace, did they not? Yes, they did. Too bad they didn't have a label on the furnace so they did not enter, okay? But you know, you talk about fiery furnaces, right? Okay? We are all headed to a furnace. We're all headed to a furnace. When we're born, we are headed to a furnace. An internal furnace. Ugh. That'd be hard, right? An internal furnace. That means that I'm weeping and gnashing of teeth we hear about. It just has to be horrible. It's hot and weeping and screaming and yelling and yelling, oh gosh. But you know, people use these when they cry, right? Sometimes tissues when they cry.
I don't
need
it.
Tell me right now, okay. We use tissues when we cry, but you know what? You know, we can get away from that sick furnace, and that is through Jesus Christ, okay? So then Jesus Christ is our Lord and Savior. Because you see, he's going to wipe away our tears, okay? And with that, we get a blank note card, okay? Because all of our sins are now washed away, okay? So it's a blank note card. And you know, all we have to do is call on him. And he is very, very, very willing to save each and every one of us when we call upon him. So we can be saved from that fire to furnace and have all our tears wiped away and have a brand new life with a brand new slate. Only in through Jesus Christ. This goes for all you guys too, in case you didn't know, okay? Children's message aren't just for children. It's actually for everybody. I think I get more of my children's service, you know what I'm saying. You want that blank card, don't you? You have a choice. We all have a choice. We can go to the fiery furnace, or we can spend an eternal life with Jesus, who will wipe away our tears and give us his grace card, which wipes away all of our sin and our iniquity. But we have to come with a repentant heart. But the way we come with a repentant heart is that we have to call upon him. He's not going to force himself on us. He's not that kind of God. We have to call upon him. And in calling upon him, we are given, well, an invitation, like we've talked about, an invitation to the manger. Within that, we get an invitation to hope and love and peace and joy. But we have to call upon Jesus and accept that invitation. Okay? So I want you guys to remember that throughout your whole life, okay? You only have to call upon him, and he will come and save you wherever you're at. And you got to trust in him. Can we say a prayer with one another this morning? Dear Jesus, we do thank you that when we call upon you, will you save us from the fiery furnace, Lord, and then you wipe our tears away, and you give us a whole new clean slate. Remind us of that, of those times that we've been going through trials, Lord, and all we need to do is call upon you, and you will save us from that trial, save us from that furnace. You will walk with us through the fire, as you did with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. You too will walk with us in that fire. And as we walk with you, we will not be burned. We thank you, for you are our Savior, you are our anchor, and you are our hope. And all of God's children said, amen, amen. So are you guys going to Sunday school this morning?
Well, not right now.
The benefits?
No, not right now, probably.